voltage source. So I will take one voltage source.
Okay, is my screen visible?
And
Yes, sir.
So, in the previous class, we completed the Thevenin theorem, right? And what was the
sir, very much noise is coming, sir.
Sir, there is background noise.
And I will again calculate the mass current, which is
the background noise is coming.
Then, algebraically, you will have to add up the currents for
okay, now is it clear?
Whatever we have calculated.
Hello, sir.
No, sir.
No, not noise. Madam is taking class. Okay. Not noise.
Is it okay?
Okay. So, in previous class, what we discussed, the Thevenin's theorem. Okay. What was in Thevenin's theorem? In Thevenin's theorem, we minimize that circuit using one open circuit voltage source and one equivalent resistance connected in series with the load resistance. Okay. And based on that one numerical also I showed you, right? Which is giving the same result like the our normal method. Right. So now we will do the previous assignment that I forgot to show you yesterday. Okay, so here you can show, you can see this circuit where this 2 ampere is here, okay, independent current source, and in parallel one resistance is connected here 2 ohm and here 5 ohm, right? And another voltage source is connected here. Now we need to calculate the current through 5 ohm resistor with the help of Thevenin's theorem. Okay, so can you tell me what should I do? What are the steps?
First, we have to calculate equivalent resistance.
Okay, but before that, you have to remove the load resistance that was given in the exam in this circuit, right? So your first step will be remove this 5 ohm. Okay, here you can see this. I am removing this 5 ohm, correct? Now we have to see from this side, and we need to calculate the equivalent resistance seen from this side. Okay, clear? Next, we need to calculate the R equivalent. Right, so how will we calculate this R equivalent? How will I calculate the R equivalent, or how will you do that?
So short circuit the voltage. This
very voltage. Good. So I will short circuit that voltage source, and because another source will be what? Current source will be what?
Open
circuited. Very good. So current source will be open circuited, and voltage source will be short circuited. So now redraw the circuit in your copy. Okay, our circuit will look like this. Okay, again this. Okay, this is our, from this side we have to see, and this is our short circuit part. Okay, and we have to look from this side, correct? So
the branch which is
contained, this 5 ohm resistor is our here, right? This is our A and B, right? This is your 1 ohm, this is your 2 ohm. Okay, now what should we do? We will calculate the R equivalent. So what will be the value of R equivalent? What is the R equivalent?
2 by 3.
Why? Explain, please. Yes, what is the resistance in this part? What is the resistance in this path?
And this diagram should go with step one.
Now, specifically,
this path is short circuited, right? So this resistance is zero. Okay. And what is the other path? This is your other path. Here 2 and 3, 2 and 1 ohm are connected in series. Look, from A to B, there are two paths. These two paths are parallel, right? So this, in this path, the equivalent, the resistance is zero. And if we move from this path, your resistance is 2 plus 1. So 3 ohm. Now what will be the R equivalent? That will be 3 parallel 0. So your R equivalent value will be 0. Is it okay? Clear hua concept?
Sir, can you please explain again?
See, which one is short circuited? Voltage source is short circuited, right? So if that voltage source is short circuited, that means this total section, this one, what is the resistance here? Short circuit means the resistance is zero. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Short circuit means resistance is zero. And what other path is present here? From A to B, this is your A, this is your B, because this is your load. Okay. So from A to B, you are moving through this 2 ohm and again 1 ohm. So these 2 and 1 ohm are in series, right? So what is the series resistance? 3 ohm. Now from A to B, I have two paths. One path of resistance 3, another of resistance 0 ohm. So what is the equivalent resistance? 3 parallel 0. So what is the value of 3 parallel 0? That is 0. Okay, clear everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this R equivalent is 0. Okay, now look, what is the open circuit voltage? What is the open circuit voltage? This voltage is across, this is your A and B, and this voltage is connected. We are calculating this voltage and check that in the circuit it is connected across the 5 volt source directly. Okay, so if it is connected across the 5 volts, it will look like this, simple. This is your positive, this is your negative. Okay, 5 volt. Correct? I need to calculate the voltage across here. Okay, so what will be the voltage across here? What is the voltage, open circuit?
R2 and R3 are in parallel.
That will be simply 5 volt. Okay. So, your VOC value is 5 volt. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, sir. Then we are moving to the next step. We want to draw the final circuit. What will be our final circuit? According to Thevenin, this will be our VOC. Okay, then our equivalent should be connected here. And as we know from the previous calculation, okay, everyone please mute yourself. Okay, please mute yourself. Okay, thank you. So here, our equivalent is present here, and here RL is connected in series. Okay, so what is the R equivalent value? That is 0. What is the VOC value? That is 5 volt. Okay. Okay, Muhammad Junaid Ansari, please mute yourself.
Okay, so now we have thank you.
Now, what is the value of RL that is given? Simple, 5 ohm.
So, V1 is here, how much?
Can you match this circuit?
20 divided
okay, by so now calculate the I. Okay, so this is your final current, 1 ampere, that will flow through this 5 ohm. That means what? In this circuit, what will be the current flowing through this 5 ohm, that will be simply 1 ampere. Okay, we are doing this whole problem using the Thevenin's theorem.
Up to I4, how we have calculated?
Okay, is there any query?
And you have written down in your copy also?
Is there any query regarding this?
Now,
I am giving you one word. Okay, try this at home. You have today's time. Try to find out this current, this 1 ampere current that will flow through this 5 ohm using our normal conventional method. Okay, or conventional method. Simple. Whether you want to do it by Mayes analysis or nodal analysis, whatever process you want. Okay, just do this problem and post that in the group. I want to see that how you can solve it. Okay. Clear to everyone? Try this. Okay, because whatever process you are doing, whatever process you want to do, same answer you will get every time. Right? So, using Thevenin's theorem, the current flowing through this 5 ohm resistor, we found out as 1 ampere. Okay? Clear? Now next we are moving to the Norton's theorem. Okay, so first one is the Thevenin's theorem, second one is the Norton's theorem. So what is basically Norton's theorem? This theorem is applicable for linear bilateral network. I have already told you, right? Just like the Thevenin's theorem. But the difference is the total circuit will shrink or will be converted into such a circuit that will contain one current source. Okay, one current source, and with it in parallel, equivalent resistance will be connected.
All of you have done that.
Okay, and with this in parallel, RL will be connected. It is the main concept. Okay, we will convert the total circuit according to the Norton's theorem such a way that the total circuit is converted into one current source, and with this current source in parallel our equivalent will be present, and with that in parallel our L will be present. Okay. Now, what is this current source? This current source is called the short circuit current. Okay, it is called short circuit current. Why it is called so? Because
20 volt resistance.
This is our load. Okay, our A B point. Now, first, what we have to do? We have to omit this load. Okay, we need to omit this load, and we do the now, short circuit.
What we will do in stage
okay.
two,
and whatever current is flowing through this path is called the short circuit current.
And the 10 volt source will be
okay. That is called ISC. In some book you will see that it is called IS or I short circuit. So based this you write ISC because it will give you the idea that it is short circuited current. Okay, that is passing through the path where the load is not present. Okay, just take the previous example. Okay, if we want to do the Norton's theorem in this circuit, okay, let me clear this one. Okay, I am just removing this portion only.
I7
is equal to the voltage source towards the load. Okay, so what is our load? 5 ohm is our load. So we will omit this 5 ohm first, just like the Thevenin theorem. And then, instead of the calculation of VOC, we will calculate the short circuit current. Okay, so how will we calculate? Our circuit will look like this is our current source. Okay, this is our current source. Okay, can you see this? Okay, where I am drawing in below. Okay,
yes sir.
Okay, very good, very good. So this is your resistance. Unmute yourself at that point where you cannot understand. Okay, I am going very slowly. This is your 2 ohm. Okay, and this is your short circuit path. And this is your voltage source. Okay. Now we have to calculate this current ISC. Okay. I have very small space to write here. So this current is called the ISC, that is short circuit current. Okay. The R equivalent calculation will remain same, whatever be the process. Okay, but the difference is in Thevenin's theorem, you have to calculate the open circuit voltage, and in Norton's theorem, you have to calculate the short circuit current. Right. So now we will do with the previous example, and we will check whether the current flowing through this load is same like the previous or not. Clear? So what we will do? First, we will omit the load. See, this is your load AB. Okay, sometimes it was written as XY. Okay, in some book it is written as XY or MN. Okay, so if that point is done, is written in your circuit, then you have to take that in your mind that yes, that point is our load point. Okay, across those points, the load is connected. We have to remove that part, whether it is resistor or inductor, whatever be the value. Okay, now see here that it is omitted, okay, short circuited. Now, this current is called the short circuit ISC. Okay, now you have to calculate this. So, what process you will follow, that's up to you. Okay, now what process I am following? Check. See, these two circuits are connected with this short circuited portion. Okay, so if you took the nodal analysis or if you took the mesh analysis, both will give the same result. So, better is here you follow no rule. Okay, better thing is you just use your own instinct. That means, see, here 10 volt is connected with the 10 ohm. Right. Now, when the current is flowing through this circuit, suppose this I1 current is flowing. Okay. Now, when this current is flowing, whether there is any resistance that will through which I2 current will flow? No, there is no element. So only I1 current is associated with this 10 ohm, and due to this 10 volt, only voltage drop that is occurring only in 10 ohm. Okay, is it clear to everyone what I said? Clear hua jo hum bataya abhi?
Yes, sir.
What I said that here in the short circuited part, in the short circuited section, यहाँ पे तो कोई भी resistance नहीं है. So since there is no resistance, so only the voltage drop that will occur due to this 10 volt is only across this 10 ohm, right? So simply V by R will give you the value of I1. So that is done here, right? So that is 1 ampere. Similar case will happen when you take this one. Okay, see, 20 volt is here, 20 ohm is here, and we are observing and we are considering that I2 current will flow in this direction. Okay, so here only voltage drop will occur at 20 ohm resistor for this 20 volt source. So only only just divide the voltage source by the resistance will give you the current passing through here. Okay, that is again 1 ampere. Now, this is again one node. Okay, what are the incoming currents? I1 is one incoming current, and here I2 is another incoming current. So there is another path through which the outgoing current will go. Okay, so that is nothing but the I1 plus I2. That is 2 ampere.
And with that, okay.
Clear was? Now, if you want to do ki sir jo bol rahe hai wo mujhe samajh mein nahi aa raha hai, so I will do the mesh analysis.
Here.
Okay, some of you may think that jo aap bata rahe hai wo samajh mein nahi aa raha hai, to hum kya karenge? I will do that. I will follow. I will solve this numerical using the mesh analysis. Okay, do that using mesh analysis. Okay, now I am doing this again with mesh analysis. Check.
You are getting the 3 ohm, 10 by 3 ohm. So these two states are clear, 24 okay. And 10 volts.
So now I am doing it using mesh analysis. So now, using mesh analysis, one current will flow through this, that is I1. Okay, now I am writing it in I1 dash. Okay, this is another process, that's why. Here I am writing I2 dash. Okay, now I am following in opposite direction.
Okay,
this direction I want to follow. Not just like the previous one. I want to do in my own way. So, what will be our voltage here? 10. Right? So, the current is flowing in this direction. That means I am doing the from negative to positive. That means our potential is rising. Correct? Positive 10. Again, current is flowing through this 10 ohm. So, this side will be positive. This side will be negative. Okay, that means voltage is dropping.
Check.
Okay, so since the voltage is dropping, so I will write here minus 10 I1. Okay, now is there any resistance connected here? No. So whatever be the current, this is I1 dash. Okay, so whatever be the current I1 dash or I2 dash, it doesn't matter. So it is simply 0. Okay, so I1 dash is 1 ampere. Correct. Now, regarding the second loop, this loop. Now, what is the equation? Now, this is your positive, this is your negative. So, potential is dropping as per our flow, current flow. So, it will be minus 20. Correct. Now, since I2 dash is following in this direction, so this side will be positive, this side will be negative, correct? So, voltage is again dropping. Here, step by step, try to understand. Minus 20 I2 dash. Okay, so you're from here, so this is equals to 0 always. Now, what is the value of I2 dash? What is the value? Tell me, what is the value of I2 dash?
1.
Plus 1.
Why it is 1? It is minus 1. Okay, just a minute. Hello? Okay, fine. So that value is minus 1. Okay, now what is the value of ISC? How much current is flowing through the short circuited path? That value will be ISC equals to I1 dash.
Okay,
and see, I1 dash flow is this side, I2 dash flow is opposite side, so it will be minus. Clear? Is it okay to you?
Yes, sir.
So,
yes, sir.
Okay, so I am writing I1 dash minus I2 dash. So, what will be the value of ISC? That is 1 minus of minus 1. That means simply 2 ampere. So it matches with our previous process, but this process is a little bit lengthy, right? Because you have to check two loops. Okay, but it will give you the same answer. So I short circuit calculation is okay. Now calculate the R equivalent here, just like the previous. So since here all the voltage sources are present, all sources are present, and they are voltage sources, so they will be short circuited.
In the similar manner, due to 10 volt source.
Okay.
So,
how they are connected, this 10 ohm and 20 ohm, they are connected in parallel because see, this is one path.
That is why in the last step,
this one is another path.
It is I5, there is a current.
Clear. So, 10 and 20 are in parallel. So, that's why calculate the RT or R equivalent, whatever you want to say. So, the value is 6.67 or 20 by 3. Okay, or you can write it 20 by 3. Now,
so that is why
do the Norton's equivalent circuit. So, according to Norton's equivalent circuit, one current source will be present here, and that source is the short circuit current. Next, in parallel with that source, the resistance must be connected here, that is R equivalent. Okay, then with this in parallel, RL will be connected. Okay, now calculate the current flow in the RL. Okay, now I already told you in what was that? The current dividing rule. Okay, in current dividing rule, I told you that current is inversely proportional to the resistance. Right, and from here, and it was derived from this equation. If you can remember, it was already given to you in the classroom that I1 equals to I total divided by R1 plus R2, and what will remain in multiplication part, that will be your R2. Okay. Okay. Can you remember this? This part, this equation we already had calculated. Okay. So using this rule, using this specific rule, we will calculate the IL here. Okay. So IL equals to ISC, that is the total current, multiplied by. What should I write here? In numerator part, what should I write? Tell me.
Solve the question. You can also solve it, but if the problem is given.
Hello, am I audible to everyone? What should I write here? In numerator part?
Then you have to. It is not that if they have not.
RL.
RL.
Why RL? Because I am calculating the current through IL, and IL is flowing through 40. So we will not consider this 40. We will consider this R equivalent, because see here,
R equivalent.
I1 current I am trying to calculate, but I am multiplying the R2 here. That's why you are getting this inverse relation. Clear hua?
Yes, sir.
So when IL current is flowing through this, we will not consider this 40 ohm. We will multiply it with the other resistor. That means here 20 by 3. Or 6.67, right? And in denominator, what should I write? That is 20 by 3 plus what? 40. Okay. Now, if you calculate this current, it will give you the same value, 0.269 or 27 something value will come. Okay. That is very simple. Whenever, always remember, this is your current, okay, yes. This is your total current I, this is your one parallel path R1, and this is another resistance R2. Okay, when I want to calculate the current flowing through I1, that is flowing through the R1. Okay, I should write here IR1 so that you can understand. So what is the value of IR1? It will be I multiply R2. I want to calculate the current that will flow through R1, but I will multiply here R2. And in denominator, it will be R1 plus R2. It is the main current dividing loop. Okay, when I want to calculate the current of IR2, what will I do? I total into R1, that is R1 divided by IR1 plus R2.
Towards the root.
Okay, clear? So the same answer you will get using the Norton's theorem. Okay, check here, the same value you will get. Okay, the R equivalent.
When we have calculated I4,
this is your I. Okay, is this another numerical? No, same numerical. Okay.
I9, it is 0 to 10 volts.
Now, this Norton theorem, this Norton theorem also is same as the current that we get using that the previous rules.
Okay.
Now, what are the process? The process is already known to you. First, what you have to do? Remove the load resistor. Then calculate the R equivalent using the short circuiting the voltage sources and open circuiting the current sources. Okay. This one many of you will forget, so please keep that in mind that voltage sources will be short circuited and current sources will be open circuited. Okay, then we will calculate the short circuit current, and this short circuit current will flow through the load by the shorted path. Okay, since this is your load, if this is your load, so you have removed the load and this is your short-circuited path. So you have to calculate the current through this short-circuited path. Okay, whatever be the current, whatever be the construction given in your exam or your as example. Okay, now you have to configure, you have to redraw the circuit. How? The current source, the short circuit current source is here. With that source in parallel, R equivalent is connected, and then RL will be connected here. Okay, so whatever current is flowing through RL, that will be the same current that will flow using the original circuit. Okay, now it's time to do one example. Now, this is one example. You can say this. Okay. Now, what is given? You have to find the Norton's equivalent circuit across the AB for the network shown. That means here, check that no load is given. The load side is already open. Check that. Is there any load connected here? No. So this load side is already open. What you have to do? You have to check whether the current sources or any voltage sources are present in the circuit and then convert them when you are calculating this R equivalent. Okay, so when you are calculating this R equivalent, what should I do? Tell me, what should I do? Hello, am I audible?
Yes. Sir.
Okay, so when I try to calculate this R equivalent, what should I do? Tell me, I already told you earlier. We are short circuiting the voltage sources. The voltage sources will be short circuited. All the voltage sources. Okay. And current sources will be open circuited. Current sources will be open circuited. Right. So using that, what will be your modified circuit? This voltage source will be short circuited. Check here. It is short circuited. Okay. Now current source is open circuited. That means through this path, no.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what is the value of R equivalent? Tell me. What is the value of R equivalent? Tell me fast, because we have very small time left.
Series, both are in series.
Why they are in series? Here, yes?
10/7.
Right, they are in parallel.
10/7.
Exactly, they are in parallel. So here it will be 5 parallel 2. That means your R equivalent value will be 5 into 2 divided by 5 plus 2. So it will be 10/7. Okay. See, don't get confused. Suppose these two resistors are connected like this. 1, 2. That means they are in series. Okay. When two resistors are connected like this, then it means they are connected as parallel. Why are you getting confused every time? Okay, some of you are confused, or many of you don't. So don't get confused. When you want to look from one side to another, check how many paths are there. If there are more than one path, that means they are connected in parallel. Okay, here is A, here is B. Okay, and you are moving. You have two ways that you can move from A to B. This is one path, okay? This one is another path using which you can move from A to B. So this is parallel. Here, this is your A, this is your B. Okay, so from A to B, you can move like this 2 ohm. Also, you can move using this 5 ohm also. So how they are connected? They are connected in parallel, not in series. Okay, so this is the calculation of your R equivalent, right?
Now, how to calculate the short circuit current? See, the load will be short circuited since no load is there. So load will be short circuited. Check the load terminals are short circuited. Okay. Now your work is to find out the load current. How will you calculate? Okay, how will you calculate? See, there is one concept here. If suppose 2 ampere current is flowing, here is one resistance, here is one short circuit. So all the shorts, this current, all the 2 ampere current will flow through this short circuited path because the resistance here is zero. This is zero resistance path. Okay, that means in this path there is nothing to resist the current flow. That's why if any resistor is connected across the short circuited path, all the current will flow through that short circuited path. Here also same thing is occurring. See, here 2 ohm is present across this short circuited path. So this 2 ohm will not play any role in your numerical when you are calculating the short circuit current. Clear? So this will be omitted. Check here in the next figure that 2 ohm is omitted. Now it's your work to calculate this short circuit current. Okay, try to calculate this one and we will check whether I will check whether you did it right or wrong in the next class. Okay, so with this I am concluding today's class. All of you give your attendance in the chat box. Okay, and if you have any query and speak.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, please can you discuss yesterday's question?
Yesterday's question means, okay, just a minute.
Because my
this
answer
one.
Is wrong. No,
okay,
sir.
This one or the other one? Okay, just a minute. Okay, just a minute. I am sharing the screen. Okay, all of you give your attendance, and if you have given, then you may leave the meeting. Okay. Okay, this question, right? Okay, is this that question you are talking about?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so which part you didn't understand?
Sir, VOC, how to calculate VOC and R.
Okay, so none of So have you tried at home?
Yes, have sir. You my,
yes, see, this is the, what was the circuit here? Okay, this one is the circuit. Original. Okay, so what are the steps for R equivalent calculation? Tell me what are the steps.
So first we emit the 5 ohm resistor.
Right, our load is this one.
Yes sir, 5
okay.
ohms.
Right, exactly. So we will omit the 5 ohm resistor. Okay, I am omitting the 5 ohm resistor. Okay, it is given wrong actually. That is not 5 ohm resistor, that will be 1 ohm connected na across this circuit.
So that's why my answer was wrong.
Okay, that is 1 ohm. Okay, very good. Take it.
So my answer was 44 by 13 because
okay.
I'm finding in 5
Fine.
Ohm.
Very good. Okay, let me do that using the 5 ohm. Okay, if
yes,
this
sir.
5 ohm is your load, then what will happen? This is your 1 ohm that is connected. This is your open circuit. That means you have omitted the load. Okay. Here 10 ohm is connected. Here 10 ohm voltage source is present. And again this 2 ampere source. Okay. Now, when you connect, when you try to look from this side, so open circuit the voltage source, open circuit the current source, okay? So I am open circuiting this current source, okay? Clear? Yes, and I am short circuiting the voltage source. Very good. So I am short circuiting the voltage source and open circuiting the
current source.
Then look that 10 and 1, they are connected in which fashion?
Parallel.
So that means 10 upon 11. Correct. 10 upon 11. So this will be 10 upon 11. So what is the VOC value? VOC value?
20.
VOC value is 20. Very good. Let me check whether VOC value you have calculated right or wrong. VOC value will be calculated across this. Okay. Now, see, when you are calculating this across the VOC, you have to take this voltage as VOC, just like the same, because these are the same point.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, what process you followed? Nodal analysis, right?
Yes, sir.
Mesh analysis?
Sir, both.
Oh, both analysis. Okay, very good. So, I am doing node analysis, right? No problem, na? So, here, 2 ampere is our incoming current. That's why it is written here. And suppose I am taking this VOC less than 10. So, this current will be incoming also. That means 10 minus VOC divided by 10, and do not forget this path because this is another outgoing path, right? So this
sir,
will
how,
be
sir how 10 minus VOC?
See, I am considering this 10 volt is higher than VOC, so in which direction current will flow? From higher voltage to lower voltage, no?
Yes, sir.
That's why.
Okay, sir.
Is it okay?
Okay,
if
sir.
I consider this VOC as greater than, VOC is greater than 10, then what will I write? I will write VOC minus 10.
Yes, correct. Sir.
And
correct, sir.
That current direction will be in opposite. So I will write in right hand side. Correct?
Yes, sir.
This one, as I considered that this 10 volt source is greater than VOC, so the current is incoming. That's why it is written here in left hand side. Correct. But if I consider the VOC is greater than 10, then your current direction will be outgoing. Correct. So
yes, sir.
I will write that time in right hand side. This side I will write. Okay, so I have considered here 10 is greater than VOC. So this one is okay to you, I think?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Okay, fine. So I am writing here VOC by 1. Is it okay? Because 1 current path is also here, that is outgoing. Okay, so this will be 2 plus 1 minus VOC by 10 equals to VOC. Now this will be 3 equals to VOC plus VOC by 10, that means 11 by 10 VOC. Is it okay? Check every calculation. Okay.
Yes, sir.
VOC value equals to 30 by 11. Correct or not? Is it okay?
It's correct.
Okay, very
yes,
good.
Sir.
So now I want to calculate what? The current flowing through this 5 ohm. Okay, now I am redrawing the circuit. How? This is our open circuit voltage source. In series are equivalent, in series are load. Okay, so what will be the current flow? Just V divided by I, V divided by R. So our voltage is 30 by 11 divided by 5
plus 10 upon 11
10 by 11. Very good. So, what is your current value? 30. 11 will be cancelled out. It will be 11, 5, 55 plus 65, right?
Yes, sir.
Is this right? So, it will be minimized to
6 by 13.
Right, 6 by 13. So, is that your answer?
No, sir, because my VOC is wrong.
Right. Every time, if you change the circuit, if you change your consideration, then accordingly your value will be changed. Okay, every time that will happen. So, you have tried, no issue. Next time you will do correct, okay? But very well done. At least you tried in different way. Very good. Okay, so everyone, give your attendance. Okay, thank you. Everyone give your attendance in the chat box. Okay, and how you will upload that class assignment? Assignment means the lab assignment. Okay, I will give you another link. Okay, I don't have time right now. Okay, in the evening I will give that link. Okay, we will discuss that later. There. Okay, fine. Okay, thank you everyone.
Okay, thank you, sir. Okay.